Cheers to the first pet I've decided to keep at home.
I'm not your pet! I'm so tired of saying that. How many times has it been? Ever since we got back, all you've had to eat is chocolate. Chocolate bread, chocolate soup, chocolate salad. Ugh. Just looking at some of these inhuman combinations makes me gag.
What are you talking about?
Chocolate is delicious.
It sharpens your mind. And it's only kind of you to celebrate the Korrigan's liberation, isn't it? They gave these to us as thanks, so that's why we have it all here. Of course, it's all because they see me as their savior for releasing them.
That may be true, but...
maybe they just pushed all their extra chocolate onto us.
Haven't you been eating the same thing for a while now, too? Do you like those candied seeds that much?
No! It's not like I really, really like them or anything.
Come on, don't blush. I know cats get high on catnip, but candied seeds in dogs?
I won't forget that slight.
Don't be shy. If you like them so much, I can candy many more of those green seeds in a little bit.
Really? No, no, no. Who would want your charity?
Not a problem. After all, it's an owner's job to take proper care of their pet.
Enough! You're gonna make fun of me? I'd rather eat nothing at all!
Listen to that. Take a look at the Hundred Knights' appetite, you dog. You should take notes.
Don't compare me to that thing! I mean, first of all, who or what is it exactly?
You must know. Old legends call it a devil, a demon, and a servant of darkness. Well, a familiar.
Old legends?
Yeah, but its existence has been debated for over 1,000 years. That's how legends go, I guess. From the depths of the underworld, 100 knights will rise and trample the heavens. The sight will extend over 10,000 miles and unlock the hollow truth of this world. Control this and control the world. Or so it says.
That's supposed to be the legend? I've never heard it before.
An excerpt from an old inscription that only witches can read.
I don't get it, but you think this is a legendary 100 knight? Even though it's one knight?
It's one knight, but it's the 100 knight that the legends speak of. I searched for it and found it. I'm not wrong.
That's a poor argument, since you're making a wild assumption.
Just get along as mutual servants of mine. Call it 100 knights. That's its name, after all.
Doesn't bite or anything, does it?
If it's not a bad move.
Nice to meet you, 100 Knight. My name is Visco Dotrish. Please call me Visco. Happy to meet me as well?
It understands our language, but it's still hard to read when it says nothing at all. Well, don't think about it too hard and just try to get along.
Like
you could use a lesson on how to get along yourself.
Well, anyway, I look forward to our time together, Hundred Knight.
Pardon me for interrupting your delicious and nutritious meal, Master. After evaluating the crack in your ring, it seems that repairing it will prove quite difficult.
No shit. If I'm not able to fix it myself, how would you ever be able to? I'll figure something out. And I'm Metallia. Remember that. This is all because the dog stole it. My ring's so valuable that if you pawned it off, you could buy a city.
Understood regarding the ring. But Master Leah, your stomach?
He's right, Metallia. What's wrong with your stomach?
Could it be that you are pregnant?
Are you trying to be funny? I'm a damn proud virgin. I probably just ate too much junk. 3 days straight of chocolate would make anyone gain some weight.
Records exist of virgin pregnancies. It is possible.
Sure, the dog had some fur, so...
What? How dare you?
Master Leah?
Somehow.
Hey, maybe you should lie down.
Shut up! Don't come near me!
Should you really act tough right now? This is no normal stomach ache. This isn't the green spot plague, is it?
Green spot plague?
It's a plague that begins with a stomach ache. And as it progresses, spotty bruises spread all over and you die.
I already knew that! This pain is different. I know this pain. This might be Lord Peptobis. Shit!
Oh, I see. Lord Peptobis. It has been quite a long time since I heard that name.
It hasn't been here in ages, so I thought it went somewhere really far away.
Lord Peptobis? Who's that? I don't get it, but are you okay?
Lord Peptobis is a god. Appears out of the forest depths whenever Master Leah does something bad. Symptoms include a circus of stomach aches, headaches, backaches, dizziness, diarrhea, pain, suffering, and vomiting. Skin.
Yeah. people told to get their kids to behave. No way, Metallia! You believe that old superstition? Superstition? Honestly, if we ignore your usual behavior, you have a really cute side too, huh? Ignorant dogs. Damn heads held high. Lord Peptobis was written in Greek Witch Urtica's Witch Doctrine, a witch specific book. Magic or something to create an antidote for your stomach ache? Peptobis or whatever aside, isn't this a chance to show off how amazing your magic is?
Stupid! Are you trying to get us all killed? Not calling it Lord... Ouch!
Lord Peptobis is immune to all witch magic. On top of that, the symptoms will only worsen.
No, Lord Peptobis. You're starting to creep me out. This isn't contagious, is it?
Don't worry. Lord Peptobis would never waste its time on a non-magic user.
Never at a loss for words, are you?
I must admit that I have never seen symptoms as bad as this.
What'll happen if you don't get better? You won't die, will you?
Previously, after a few days, she would heal right up, almost as if she was faking, never sick. Suffering like this is indeed a first.
Darker than usual right now?
Her hair looks the same as ever to me, but...
Hair is influenced by magic and responds accordingly. I'm sure my shitty condition is to blame for any color change you see.
It is possible that Master Leah's magic powers have been drained. It may prove challenging to tough it out for several days.
How can you be so calm about it? She's suffering a great deal. Isn't there something we can do?
As a matter of fact, I have nothing to suggest, yes. But in the Western Mountain Valley, I do recall that a shaman lives there who specializes in exorcisms.
Where'd you learn that?
I overheard some birds having a conversation deep in the mountains the other day.
Birds talking? Are you serious? I mean, you always lie with such a straight face, so...
I've heard a similar rumor from a witchcraft professor before. In the Forbidden Lands, there's someone who cures witches for a living.
Better not be another witch. If another witch sees me like this, I'd rather just die. Ow, ow, ow!
Idiot, this is no time to act tough.
I have no further information regarding the shaman. Something else, or perhaps not even a human. Anything is possible, yes.
Jeez. Useless. Well, whatever. It's a side job while we make the pillars bloom. Got that, Hundred Knight. Release the pillars, find the shaman, and get me some medicine. Head to the... what? Ravine. You look so apathetic. But you realize I don't know what'll happen to you if I die, right? My magic and your existence are linked. My death might nullify the contract, or you might die with me.
Enough talking. Arlecchino, lend me a hand, would you? We need to take her to her bed, okay?
With Master Leah in this condition, it will be difficult to use certain things and guide Sir Hundred Knight.
We have to let her do it. And there's no choice. And I can't help but grit my teeth when talking to her. Arlecchino, call for money.
Could be.
She's close, trust me. Her hearing surprises even me.
Master Bonnie? Who is it this time?
Master Bonnie is a rogue fairy. Her outrageousness is comparable to Master Leah. One would doubt she is truly a fairy. Because she is such a punk, such a grand creature, yes.
Hey! What the? Hey! I just happened to be spying on you guys, and that is my intro? Fairy? Are you okay? You have shards of glass sticking out of your head. Surprised you, then maybe it was a bit too much to do in front of a human. You were cursed to turn into a doggy! Bark, bark! Come on, bark for me! No! And... long time no see, Leah! But, like, what happened to you? Personality got worse? Anyway, what happened?
Master Bonnie, it is not her eyes that have gone bad or her personality. It is her health, yes.
Huh? Isn't that what I said? Well, whatever. I was just imitating you, Arlie.
I am extremely humble.
Say what I want. I'll remember this later. Ow, ow.
Aw, don't get mad at me, Leah. I get the picture. You need me to navigate this thingy, right?
Here. Guide the Hundred Knight to the shaman or whatever. And get me some damn medicine.
You should get some rest. It's a promise between you and me. Don't worry. Just leave it to your best fairy pal, Money.
It's a promise. Ugh.
Metallia!
Hundred Knight, I'm sorry, but I must stay here and watch over Metallia. Even though she is who she is, I can't leave her alone when she's suffering so much.
Thank you for your concern, Master Visco.
Just Visco is fine, really.
I see. Then please refer to me as Butler Lord... harlot you. Let us away to the second floor.
Chapter 4, The Witch and the Ancient Ravine.
Thank you. Yeah.